With brothers like these, who needs YouTube drama? Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 worst Paul Brothers moments. Before we begin, we publish new videos every day, so be sure to subscribe for more great content. For this list, we're looking at the worst controversies and poorest content produced by both Jake and Logan Paul. Both brothers have become recognizable figures of the YouTube platform, as well as the mainstream media. However, most of this attention is for all the wrong reasons. Number 10, Jake Paul vs. Dad Kissing Competition. In a vlog uploaded on the 19th of May 2017, Team 10 and Jake's father are seen arguing about who the best kisser is.
I mean, cool, right?
They decide to put this to the test by kissing the same girl and letting her decide. They claim that the judge is open to the concept, since she's getting a shout out in return. The video ends with both Jake and his father kissing the same girl just seconds apart. This is both an uncomfortable watch and a questionable content decision by Jake and the rest of Team 10.
We are doing things we-
And this wasn't the last Jake Paul kissing contest either. Number 9, exaggerated colorblindness. Logan Paul decided to make a video about a pair of glasses that could cure his colorblindness. In the video, he's seen putting on the glasses and looking at the sunset. From the over-the-top acting to the emotionally manipulative music.
Hi guys, I'm a little bit sick today, so sorry for the late video, but I'm Shakar from iGaming, and today we're doing things we all do. Let's do this. The first one...
the attention of H3H3 and iDubbbz, who ended up parodying scenes from the original vlog. Logan then admitted months later that he did indeed act for a lot of the video. Number 8, fake arrest. In the midst of a summer full of controversy for Jake Paul, he decided to teach a questionable lesson to his audience. According to him, the premise of this video is to show that people shouldn't believe everything in the media. Instead, it feels like Paul's just courting more controversy by staging a fake arrest. The whole situation was made worse when it was brought to the public's attention that impersonating a police officer with the intent of deception is illegal in the state of California.
Shakar for gaming here today.
It doesn't help that he was involved in another police prank just months later. Not the best impression to make when the whole world is watching. Number 7, Jake Paul doxes Post Malone. Before he pretended to get arrested, Jake Paul ran into some problems with rapper, singer, and internet sweetheart Post Malone. In a vlog that's since been removed from Paul's channel, he visits Malone's house to give him some merch. There are several problems with this. First of all, he obtained Post's address through the merch company. He had the front of Post Malone's house filmed without permission.
Thank you, sir.
The door number is censored. However, license plates and the house itself are still visible. Both Jake and Post went on to the H3 podcast on separate occasions to discuss the issue, with Malone claiming that everything was okay and that he accepts Paul's apology. Number 6, YouTube stars diss track. This is a very odd diss track, mostly because it starts with Paul claiming that it isn't a diss track at all, and because it has nothing to do with YouTubers. Instead, the whole song is Paul's way of retaliating against news outlets and the media. Unfortunately for him, reaction to the video didn't go the way he planned. In order to show that he's not a bad person, Jake lists good things that he's done before, including doing charity work. This not only seems boastful, it also doesn't erase his past bad behavior. Many have reacted to this video by explaining that good deeds don't just cancel out bad deeds. Number 5. It's every day, bro.
But I'm from Ohio, the white boy.
One of the most memed videos of 2017, It's Every Day Bro was considered a laughingstock across the internet, with many people making reaction videos to the song.
This is the type of shit that I was making when I was 14.
This includes Post Malone and even Logan Paul himself.
And when you're struggling for content, sometimes the solution is to go out and make a shit song.
Along with many members of Team 10, Jake raps about his ex-girlfriend, threatens to become bigger than PewDiePie, and discusses his merchandise, which apparently is selling like a god at church. This song also features the now infamous Nick Crompton line.
England is my city.
A song made up almost entirely of inaccurate statements and boasting does not make for the best music video.
It's every day, bro!
Yo, it's Esther Brooks, the competition show.
Number 4, the Alyssa Violet scandal. This entry is slightly more serious than a poor music video. Shortly after the release of It's Everyday Bro, former Team 10 member Alyssa Violet went on camera and discussed the problems that she had with Jake Paul.
There's nothing I could do about it because, like, it's his house. I'm in a contract with him.
She explained how while they were together, he would bring other girls to their house and she would have to hear them making out.
Like, I had to look these girls in the eyes and, like, know that they were hooking up with Jake.
Alyssa openly discussed the mental damage caused by their relationship. After this, she appeared in Jake Paul diss tracks by both Ricegum and Logan Paul. The confession video caused some damage of its own to Jake's public image and sparked a lot of backlash against Paul and his friends. Number 3. Team 10 ruins the neighborhood. During Jake Paul's summer of controversy, local Los Angeles news station KTLA-5 aired a story that displayed the chaos that Team 10 was causing in their neighborhood. They showed Paul setting furniture alight inside his backyard swimming pool, as well as the rambunctious masses of fans that would wait outside the building all day. One neighbor even described the place as a war zone.
And we're more than happy to have them live here if they're respectful of their neighbors, but they're not.
Jake Paul himself cameos in the segment and is asked about his thoughts on the matter. His response is to jump on the news van, sarcastically apologize, and insult the reporter's shoes.
I don't think they're so bad.
Number 2. Use of the N-word in freestyle rap. In early 2018, a video surfaced of Jake Paul using some questionable language.
Whip it. Like my
The video, which was allegedly recorded at the Coachella Music and Arts Festival, sees Jake freestyling over an instrumental. In his rap, he uses the N-word on two occasions. While people close to Paul have stated that this is not representative of his actual personality, it isn't the first time he's ended up in hot water due to racist remarks.
Where are you from?
I'm from Kazakhstan originally, but...
Oh. It sounds like you're just gonna blow someone up.
In the summer of 2017, a vlog showed Paul mocking a Kazakhstani fan's accent, jokingly saying that he sounds like he's going to, quote, blow someone up.
Send the nuke!
Number 1. Logan Paul in the Aokigahara Forest. While vlogging in Japan, Logan visited the Aokigahara Forest, which is colloquially known as the Suicide Forest. He decided to film his journey and ended up spotting a man that had taken his own life. Logan's reaction was in very poor taste. He's seen laughing at the man, as well as getting close and filming the body from mere feet away. This sparked more backlash than either Paul brother had ever seen before. Covered internationally, as well as discussed by many celebrities on social media, Logan took the video down and uploaded an apology. The video was controversial not just for Logan, but for YouTube as a whole.
Don't tell me I didn't monetize. You knew this was gonna go viral, and that instantly increases who you are.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out these other great clips from WatchMojo and subscribe for new videos every day.